大家好. Welcome to Forestry 350 Foundational Field School, though we usually just call this course Fall Camp. I'm Patrick Culbert. I'm an assistant professor of teaching in the Department of Forest and Conservation Sciences here at UBC. Most students just call me Patrick, but you're welcome to call me Dr. Culbert or Professor Culbert if that makes you feel a little bit more comfortable. I know I've taught a number of you in person in Zhejiang or Fujian, and I taught a bunch of you online earlier this summer as well. So I'm really looking forward to meeting you in person eventually, though I realize it might be a little while. I really love teaching this course. It's my favorite course at UBC. I feel like if you're learning about forests, if you're studying forests, the best place to do that is in a forest. I love teaching in the field, and at UBC Forestry, we really believe strongly in field instruction. So this is a wonderful course. Obviously, you aren't able to join me in the field, and that's really unfortunate. But I didn't want to cancel this course outright. I feel like this is a really important course for incoming 3+2 and 2+2 students like yourselves. I view it kind of as a transition course. You get some time in the field, you get context about British Columbia forests so that when you're taking your fall courses, you have some mental images and you have an idea of what these forests actually look like. And I think that really will help with you learning the material in your fall courses. So I'm going to do my best to do an online version. We won't be able to do nearly what we do in the field, but I hope that I can still get you part of the way there. When I teach this course in person, I have three goals. The main goal is to introduce you to the forests of British Columbia, give you some context, help you understand the ecology, the trees, the plants, the soils, and also for you to learn field skills, how to work in the forest, how to use different forestry tools or different techniques that you'll need to use for your courses. My other goal for this course in particular is to help you become more familiar with a Western style of teaching. Again, you're transitioning from your Chinese universities to UBC, and the style of teaching is going to be quite different here than you're used to. The other goal for this course is to give you some practice speaking English. It's really brave of you to be moving to a foreign country to study in a foreign language, and I know it's really challenging. When I talk to 3+2 students, they always tell me that the language is the biggest challenge to their study here. I've lived abroad, and I know how hard it can be to speak in a foreign language, especially when you're surrounded by friends who speak your native language. So we're really going to try to practice that in this course. You don't have to feel embarrassed about your English at all. All of the students in this course are English language learners. 我的中文很不好. So I don't expect you to speak perfect English either. In fact, I'm very happy for you to make mistakes because that tells me that you're trying and learning. So this will be a good opportunity for you to practice your English, especially in a forestry context. I think the more that you do that, the easier your subsequent courses will become. So it's going to be hard work, but it will help you in your subsequent courses. I think we can probably still accomplish these goals, even in an online setting. Giving you a feel for these forests is going to be the biggest challenge, obviously, because you aren't going to be able to be in them. But it's about a month before the course right now when I'm filming this. I've got some cameras and some other equipment that I'm taking out into the field with me, and I'm going to do my best to create activities that help you feel like you're in the forest. And I think we can do these other things too. I'm really interested in having a lot of interaction with you. I don't want this to be a course where you're just watching a few videos and taking some online multiple choice quizzes. That's not how this course is going to operate. I really enjoy interacting with students in this course. In a field school, I can chat one-on-one with students. I can talk with small groups of students while we're sitting around eating lunch. We can look around in the forest, talk about what we're seeing. It's very different than in a large lecture, so I really appreciate it. And it's going to be hard to do that in this course, especially given the time difference. While you're learning, I'm probably going to be asleep. But I have a few ideas, and I have some things that we can do to help you have a lot of interaction with other students, including students you haven't met yet, as well as interacting with me. In order for us to accomplish these goals, I have a few things to ask of you. The first is just to be patient with me. Taking a field course and putting it online is not something I would recommend. I'm going to do my best, but I know I'm going to run into some things that don't work as well as I had hoped, or run into some technical challenges. So please be patient with me. I will do the same with you. I know that you might run into some technical challenges on your end, and I know that none of you signed up for this as an online course. None of you chose to have an online course. You would rather be in the field. So we'll work together and try to make the best of it. The other thing that I ask of you is just to be fully engaged in this course. Like I said, I want to have interaction with you, and I think it'll make the course work a lot better for everybody if we can have a lot of interaction with one another so it doesn't feel quite so isolating. I'm really looking forward to teaching you. I think that this is going to be a great course. 谢谢大家, 再见.